Baltimore Mayor Sheila Dixon was officially sworn in today as the city's first female African-American mayor. With today's ceremony came some promises reflective of her campaign. 11 News reporter Kate Amara is live at City Hall. She has more for us. Kate?
Today's inaugural ceremony was called a symbol of Baltimore's progress and promise.
And laws thereof.
And support the Constitution.
Baltimore Mayor Sheila Dixon showed just how well prepared she is for the job as she was sworn in, flanked by her two children and ready to repeat after Governor Martin O'Malley. Dixon began administering the oath to herself.
Without partiality or prejudice.
Execute the office.
Execute the office of mayor
of the city of Baltimore.
We asked after the event, had she practiced the lines beforehand? Nope, Dixon said. It's habit. She's been swearing in city leaders since being elevated to mayor back in January.
That it was just kind of an automatic rhythm because I have to give the oath.
Dixon also said she wanted those attending the inaugural ceremony to feel her spirit on this day. That stage filled with city, state, and federal leaders, Senators Cardin and Mikulski, former Mayor Schmoke and D'Alessandro. Dixon was introduced by the governor.
A city's success depends on the goodness of its people, and I know that our city will thrive under her very capable guidance and nurturing of that goodness.
In her inaugural address, Dixon outlined policy priorities for her administration and promised progress within 2 years on strengthening families, ending homelessness, and cracking down on crime.
While I'm pleased that we are making progress, there is still considerable work to be done. We need to raise our expectations and lower our tolerance for what is acceptable levels of violence. It's time for us to hold ourselves to a higher standard.
The mayor swore in Controller Joan Pratt this afternoon. See, she wasn't kidding about that. And the party continues tonight with the inaugural ball. It's at the Baltimore Convention Center downtown. Some 3,000 ticket holders will be on hand. Reporting live at City Hall, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.